first of all, I'm so proud of you. You know, we go back. We go back.
Yeah, we definitely go back.
I appreciate your support always. Yeah. Because when I was a part of a lot of live music events in Atlanta, you always came through. You always delivered the vocals, always supported. It's been such an amazing moment to watch your evolution. Mm. The continued success. I can't say the new success, the continued success.
Yeah.
So, Vedo, how have you evolved the most from the voice to now?
Oh, man. I've grown tremendously. Not just in music or not just in skill, but as a person, you know. I've learned how to move amongst the wolves, they would say. I've learned to not lead with my emotions, but lead with logic. Because, you know, coming up, you know, in this industry, man, if you don't know what is what and how things work, it tends to come off as shady when it's truly just business. So like I said, I've grown in that matter. I've grown as a businessman. I'm a father now, so I'm much.
Congratulations.
I've always been, thank you. I've always been a loving person, but I'm a much more understanding and patient and a compassionate lover right now. So it's all up. It's all good.
I love that. Okay, let's see. How does it feel to have a platinum single in this era with You Got It?
Platinum single. Yo.
In this time.
As an R&B artist.
Right.
I would say that's probably the next best thing to having my daughter. My daughter's number one, and you know, just feeling to actually be certified gold and platinum within
yes.
a 6 month span.
Yes, that's a hard beat.
It's amazing, and independent too.
Yes.
I'm still on a high. You know, I'm still on like a natural high because everything is still moving so fast, and it's just a blessing. I'm learning to take everything in and just kind of use the momentum to keep going.
Did you foresee the success? Like, did you predict it, or was like, oh my God?
Yeah, I definitely seen it for seeing the success. I just didn't overcome that fast.
Well, for the single.
For the single, mm-hmm. Yeah. I mean, and that goes into saying like, you just gotta be ready.
Yeah.
Like, I don't think God would have allowed me to be in this position if he knew I wasn't ready. So it's like you never know when it's gonna happen.
Stay ready.
You just gotta stay ready.
That's
so true. So I definitely saw it happen. I just didn't think it was gonna happen with that particular song and this song.
Wow.
Yeah.
I think the song's relatable though to women.
Yeah.
Cause like some of my friends were going through some stuff. I'm like, put that Vedo on. Like, F that. You know.
Yeah.
Forget him.
But,
so.
I wanted the song to do. Mm-hmm. Those were my intentions. Were to. Give females that spark.
That empowerment.
That empowerment, that boost of confidence. To not only be a woman and be beautiful, but be a self-sustainable woman. Because women are the foundation. And a lot of men, I've been guilty of this too, but almost kind of enabling a woman to be her, you know what I'm saying? Be her best self because you the man. You want to take care of everything. Don't worry about nothing. Nah, I'm going to still take care of everything, but I want you to have your own there. You know what I'm saying? I want you to have your own. And that came with growth. You know, that came with growth, you know, growing up and saying, you know what, it's boss-like to be able to take care of everything, you know what I'm saying, and your family got to worry about nothing. But it's even more boss-like to boss your spouse up, knowing that if there's ever a situation where I need you to step forward, you can step forward.
That's true. That is true. What can fans expect from the new forthcoming single, Yesterday?
Oh, man. Vibes. Literally, just the vibe. This single just reeks of nostalgia.
Nice.
You know what I mean? It's like, it gives you that nice, like, you know, you got an old-fashioned drink, you know what I'm saying, whiskey, you know what I'm saying, whatever, you know, you smoking your hookah, smoking a cigar, you just kicking it, and you bopping.
Mm-hmm.
It's just a bop, you know, it's a feel-good record, you know, it's very relatable. It takes you back to the, you know, late 90s,
okay.
Early 2000s.
It's classic feel.
Yeah, exactly, you know, very easy on the ears. I think that, a lot of music today got so much shit going on
mm-hmm.
in it, from the vocals to the beat. People kind of get lost in all of that. But this record kind of just, it's across the board, man. You get what you get, you know what I'm saying? And you're going to like it. It's infectious, for sure.
So what I've loved about you is you've always been true to the genre. You've always been true to R&B. You've always been true to real music. Issa Rae recently tweeted that she was listening to Mint Condition's Breaking My Heart. Yeah. She said, like, people are not desperate enough, not dramatic enough. Yeah. Desperate isn't like the begging, the love, the real vocals and emotions. Do you plan on, I can't say bringing that back, but do you plan on continuing to have that in your music?
Oh, for sure, man. R&B is love. R&B is sadness. R&B is desperateness. R&B is happiness. Mm-hmm. R&B is everything. I think you can't truly have an R&B song or be an R&B artist if you can't display those qualities and let those emotions transcend mm-hmm. to the next person. To be R&B is to be all of those things. So I feel like, I'm a break down and, you know, be cheated on. I'm a cheat on. I'm a love. I'm gonna be, you know what I'm saying?
Right. Like, R&B gave you a song that's to everything.
Exactly.
Anything you were going
everything,
through.
Everything, man. I think R&B, it just shouldn't be about sex. It just shouldn't all be about love. Mm-hmm. It should literally be about life.
Life, absolutely. Yeah. I agree. What has life for Vedo been like in the pandemic?
Oh, it's been great, actually. You know, minus the, I think I had COVID back when it first started. But other than me being scared to hell, because I had my baby in the midst of a pandemic, mm-hmm. so I was scared. Like, I didn't want nobody around me, nobody mm-hmm. anything. But other than that, man, it was good. Business was good. I'm independent, so you know, when everybody was in the house and, you know, couldn't go nowhere, they were streaming songs and YouTube videos. I was getting paid.
Yes.
So,
always
good. Yeah, I was getting paid, so that was a blessing, man. Like I said, started a family, got to know my daughter, got to know my girl even more. Just, you know, reflected on things. I got closer to certain family members that I didn't talk to. And honestly, it was because of the pandemic and how fast people were losing their lives. It made you think, like, man, that could have been somebody.
Reach out.
You know, that could have been somebody I knew. So definitely made me recalibrate how I move and take a little time and sit back and send that text out.
Right, for sure. Who's been your favorite artist to write for? Because you've written for some big artists. I need you to name drop. This is the moment. You can tell everybody, for those who don't know, some of these artists that you've written for.
I would say Usher. Mm-hmm. You gotta say Usher. Everybody was cool. LMA was definitely dope to work with. Amazing, actually. Chris Brown, absolutely amazing. August Alsina, cool, dope as hell. All my K-pop people, my K-pop artists that I write for, amazing. Super
K-pop
talented.
Checks.
Yeah.
Coming in.
For sure. But I would say Usher, man, simply because, you know, you take somebody that's like me, who's 28 years old, and grew up listening to Usher, like, you know, listening to Chris Brown, listening to these artists that are mega stars now. You know, we only call them superstars,
right?
Mega stars.
Absolutely.
Just to be able to sit in the same room with him and say, hey, this is a song I wrote, and he like it. And as he goes to record it, you know, this Usher. You think like, oh, that's Usher. He can do that. Mm-hmm. You know, see, he can do that by himself. But he's such a student of the game.
Alexander.
He's like, yo, I'm in that vocal producing. The guy that I watch.
Isn't that amazing?
Literally vocal. Like, nah, Usher, don't do that. No. You put too much on it. Ease back. You know what I'm saying? Like, you gotta. Ooh, like, just vocal producer Usher through a song?
That's epic.
I'm like,
that's pretty legendary.
Like, yes, that's crazy.
And he believed in you too, from the voice.
Yeah, from the jump. I literally was the only contestant that he actually kept in contact, exchanged numbers.
Wow.
You know, after I got eliminated off the show.
Wow. Yeah. And see, that didn't stop anything.
Nah, absolutely.
You won't. What's meant to be will be.
You know what I'm saying? The only artist from the whole show that has a platinum single.
Wow.
And didn't win.
See?
Yeah.
Vedo, okay? Top 5 singers that are live.
Oh, Stevie Wonder, Michael Jackson, Usher, Whitney Houston, damn show. Luther. Say.
Okay.
Yeah.
What's next for Vedo?
Oh, man, just everything. The single dropping yesterday is dropping
midnight
along with the music video. Album is coming mid-September, so that's going crazy. I'm getting into some acting. Some acting roles. We got some things that we're working on now. I do got a little acting skills, you know what I'm saying?
Can't wait to see you on the big screen.
I'm kind of trying to touch on different things. You know, I'm getting into stocks and stuff like that. Trying to get into real estate, all that good stuff. I'm just trying to stay busy, man. I want the world to know me for music, you know, and writing these great songs. But I want to create a legacy that, oh, nah, Vedo wasn't just a singer, songwriter, an artist. Like, this man really had his hands in everything.
Yes, that.
You know? So, yeah, everything, baby. I'm working. There's nothing more to say. I hate to feel this way. This ain't how love should be.